guys, this is Kevin, and welcome to my channel. Here is my latest creation, a 4x4 pickup truck. In this video, I'm going to tell you the story about designing this mock and the main feature of it. Let's get started. This model is based on Toyota Tundra, if you can tell, but I didn't actually name it Tundra mostly because the overall proportion is way off from the real truck, and some details are not quite the same. The project started from the drivetrain, which we'll talk about later, and when I was looking for bodywork for the model, this truck just came to my mind. It has openable doors, engine hood, tailgate, and working headlights. The battery is located in the back seat. By simply detaching these two cables from the rail, you can have access to the charging port. I also made an additional bed cover. It could be easily attached to the bed and folded up just like this. It's not an easy thing to design an authentic bodywork at this scale, so I have to make details less prominent by using half stud offset. You can find those subtle half stud protrusions on the wheel arch, door panel, as well as the front grille. Also, the upper parts of the front fender and the door panel are slightly slanted to match the curve of the panel on the bed. The truck is driven by a single axle motor and steered by a servo motor. Both front and rear axles have live axle suspensions. It features a unique drivetrain with dual drive shaft. So how does it work? Let's take a look at the rear axle since both axles have similar structures. This is a simplified version of it. As you can see, it has two power inputs, each connected to a 16-tooth gear, meshes with either of the two 20-tooth gears on both sides of the gear housing, and together they drive a single differential. So in order for this setup to work properly, the two drive shafts have to rotate in opposite directions. Note that the teeth of the differential gets in the way of the drive shaft, so the shorter one always needs to be on the side which has the teeth, while the longer one on the other side. That makes an interesting and also unexpected effect while designing it, which is the two drive shafts which are on the same axis that goes to the rear and to the front respectively, also rotate in opposite directions, no matter how you set up the two differentials, this way or this way. I think that's a bonus point for rock crawling situations. The truck will less likely to roll over. As for the center part of the drivetrain, this runner explained it quite well. A single power output is geared down and distributed to two drive shafts on two different axes, one to the front, one to the rear. Then meshed 16-tooth gears are used to create equal speed rotations in opposite directions. The model actually runs pretty slow, but you know, it's an off-road truck, not a supercar, and it's only a matter of gear combinations, so I'm really not too concerned. Okay, so why using dual drive shaft? Well, I've been troubled by the vulnerability of LEGO parts for a long time. I mean, they're so easily damaged when working under a heavy load, especially those related to power transmission, like bevel gear, differential, universal joint, etc., and they're always crucial to the drivetrain. One simple way that I can think of to solve this problem is to distribute torque by using multiple drive shafts. Madoka has already made a great example of this theory. Make sure to check out his excellent Shaman mock on his channel. Actually, this is the second mock that I built with dual drive shaft, the first one being my Mitsubishi Pajero. It uses CV joint instead of universal joint, and is only rear-wheel drive due to wheelbase concerns. Both models have live axles. With this setup, you don't lose the benefit of differential while cornering, and the differential is less likely to slip when driven by two gears on each side. These two models are designed mostly for experimental purposes. They have simple functions, and they are not even heavy enough to fully utilize the drivetrain. But I think it's a good start and a good attempt. Maybe this theory will show its true value on my future mocks with bigger, heavier, and more complex structures and functions. So stay tuned! Lastly, I have created building instructions for this mock, and I will post a link in the descriptions below when it's available on rebrickable.com. Alright guys, that's all I want to share with you in this video. I hope you enjoyed. Leave a comment if you have any questions. Make sure to subscribe to my channel, and I will see you next time.